Hello everyone, my name is Vikal Jain and today I am going to deal with intersections and conditional formatting intersection. So in this video, we are going to cover how to find intersection based on the data validation. Like this. Then we are going to find out the intersection based on the conditional formatting. And at the last, we are going to find out how to deal with duplicate data in conditional formatting while dealing with intersections. So let's begin. So first part is we are going to find out the intersection based on data and without conditional formatting. So we are going to use index and match over here. So match, I'm not taking the original cell, I am taking the helper cell. So match, lookup value is product 3. Lookup array would be A4 to A9. Let's lock it. Press F4 key, comma 0. Now my product 3 is lying on the third position. Let's find out the position of data 3 in this data. So match, lookup value is this, comma, lookup array is this. Now F4 to lock, comma, match type 0. Now data 3 is again on the position number 3. If I will change it, it will automatically change. I have created this list based on the data validation. Now we are going to use the index. But before using index, we are going to store these value in our clipboard. So I'm opening my clipboard over here. Here on the home tab, we have clipboard. So open it. Now in the edit mode, I'm copying it, copy. And here I'm again going to copy it, copy. So now index, array is this data, lock it, comma. Now row number would be the lookup array in which product is containing. So we have find out the product number on this match. So here is this match appearing, comma, and the column number would be your data reference. So data number is calculated based on the first match. So here, now close the parentheses and enter. Now we have find out the intersection based on the match and index. Now it is working fine. Now let's deal with the conditional formatting. Here we are going to take the four steps. First, we are going to find out the exact column. For example, in data 3, we are going to highlight this column. Then in product 3, we are going to highlight this column. Then the third step would be finding the intersection. And the fourth step would be dealing with the duplicates. So let's begin. So we are going to deal with the column first. So I am selecting my columns. Now conditional formatting, new rule. So in this conditional formatting, we are going to use a formula. Now I am going to check the first row. So I am going to freeze the row whether it is equal to my data 3. Now the format, green, okay, and okay. Now see, if I will change it, it will automatically change. Now let's begin with the second conditional formatting. Here we are going to highlight the row number based on this product 3. So select your row, conditional formatting, new rule. Now use the formula. Now this time I am going to fix my column, not the row, equal to product 3. Now I'm going to take the format. Now here is the intersection and here is the value. The value is correct. What about the case? Here we have data 3 and product 3. Now see, this value is appearing two times. Let me highlight this. Let me choose yellow color. So my yellow color is not appearing here because condition formatting is overruling it. Now we are going to deal with it. So I am going to highlight the intersection part. For this we need to select only the data, not the row and the columns, not the headers. So conditional formatting, new rule, use a formula. And I'm not fixing any row and column, equal to this one. Now format dark red and color is white, font color is white. Okay. Now see, here's the problem. If my value would be duplicate, so it is going to highlight both the values simultaneously. So what if I want to highlight only the intersection value, not the duplicate one? Now here is the fourth scenario. So all condition we need to check simultaneously. We need to check the column name, we need to check the row name, then at the last we need to find out the intersection. Now we are going to cheat over here. So open condition formatting and manage rule. So I am finding all the rules on this worksheet. Here we have covered three rules. So I am opening my first rule, copy and paste it here. Again I am doing this condition formatting, manage rules, this worksheet. This time I am copying second rule, paste. Again condition formatting, manage rules, this worksheet, and the third rule is this. Now paste it here. Now I am going to take the end function reference, because end function can check all the conditions simultaneously. Now again we are going to take help of the clipboard. So let's store these three values in the clipboard. Open the clipboard. So as I have copied the values, so it has already stored because I have once opened it. So if you will open the clipboard once, it will automatically store in the backend. So here it is. Now I'm going to take the reference of end function and now open the clipboard, insert your first logical condition, now comma, insert your second logical condition, comma, insert your third logical condition and enter. Don't worry about the answer. So let's copy the formula and again select the cells, conditional formatting, new rule, use a formula. Now this time I am going to paste the function here. Now format, fill, dark blue and font is white. Okay. Now see, it is only highlighting the intersection, not highlighting the other one. If I will change the value like this, so it is taking the intersection only, it is not taking the duplicate. If I will copy the value here, see, it is the second value, but it is not highlighting the, it is not overruling the intersection. So this is the intersection and condition formatting intersection part. So keep enjoying and keep learning.